Now we have in verse 2, a fool hath no delight in understanding, but that his heart may discover itself. This is something we've had before, but this professor I told you, he sent me a bunch of proverbs that are up to date that are very interesting. Here's one that fits in here. If I stop to think before I speak, I won't have to worry afterward about what I said before. Well, that certainly is true. And then in verse 3, when the lawless cometh, there cometh also contempt and with ignominy reproach. They bring great sorrow into the world. In fact, all of these that he mentions through here are like that. And again, let me refer you to a proverb that this professor sent me. He says, some persons cause happiness wherever they go, others whenever they go. I think that's a good one, by the way, and it sure applies to this crowd that the Lord's talking about here. Now we are told in verse 4, the words of a man's mouth are as deep waters, and the wellspring of wisdom as a flowing brook. This is something that is very important for the child of God, because every believer is indwelt by the Holy Spirit. You remember the Lord Jesus stood there that day when all that water was poured out at the time of the Feast of Tabernacles. If any man thirst, he said, let him come unto me and drink. He said, he that believeth on me, as the Scripture hath said, out of his belly or inmost being shall flow rivers of living waters. Now, John interprets that for us, and he says, this spake he of the Holy Spirit. And that is something that's very important that we speak. A child of God should learn to try to speak in the power of the Holy Spirit, and how important it is to speak in the power of the Holy Spirit in presenting the Word of God, in talking about the things of God. Now, verse 5, it's not good to accept the person of the lawless, to overthrow the righteous in judgment. Do not compromise with an evil person or a lawless person in order to overthrow a righteous person. I'm wondering today if we as a nation haven't butted in to many places where we should have kept our nose out, and we would not be in the difficulty that we find ourselves. And that's true, of course, of individuals. These are great proverbs that are practical, that can be geared into life. Now he moves down and begins to talk about the fool again. Remember, the Lord Jesus said, don't you call anybody a fool. God does it because he seems to have done a pretty good job of it. He says now here, a fool's lips enter into contention, and his mouth calleth for strokes. A fool's mouth is his destruction, and his lips are the snare of his soul. The words of a whisper are as dainty morsels, and they go down into the depths of the soul. Now here again you have that matter of a fool that is one that is stirring up contention. He's issuing a complaint. He's finding fault, that type of thing. May I give you another proverb that's a modern one that the professor sent me? Listen to this one. This is a good one. Be considerate. Most people know how to express a complaint, but few utter a gracious compliment. The bee is seldom complimented for making honey. It's just criticized for stinging. My friend, that's a good proverb that brings all of this right up